It's been called a miracle medicine that some claim can slow aging, increase energy, and even help you lose some weight.
So what's the buzz about peptide therapy? Liv Johnson dug into the phenomenon and why it's not being embraced by mainstream doctors.
I'll let you know what's free.
Joseph Turchetti has been visiting Aspire Rejuvenation Clinic in Orlando to receive peptide therapy for 3 years. Once a week, he receives a complex B injection that he says has made a drastic difference in his energy levels.
I was always pretty active, but a lot of people that are like half my age that I work with, and I'm like dancing around them now.
It's why peptide therapy is gaining more and more popularity. But what is it exactly? Well, there are already thousands of peptides in your body. They are the building blocks of proteins and are composed of amino acids that work to regulate a variety of biological functions and processes. You might recognize the peptide insulin, which helps your body turn food into energy and controls your blood sugar levels. Dr. John Carazella was a practicing orthopedic surgeon for more than 25 years. He now works at the Florida Center for Hormones and Wellness, where he helps patients overcome hormonal deficiencies, sexual dysfunction, and nutritional imbalances. He says his journey into hormone therapy started when his wife went through a traumatic menopause and finally found relief through peptides.
We did the creams and we did the pellets and we did the injections and we did everything. And finally, we settled upon a provider that literally was life-changing. I mean, literally was like turning back the clock.
It's the same kind of success stories that led Tomo Marjanovic to open Aspire Rejuvenation Clinic. He says he wanted to be able to treat people with a holistic approach and avoid what he calls a band-aid approach.
These are things happening in your body anyway. We're introducing them and they are signaling your body to produce more of a hormone or to heal something. So, you know, when I have tendonitis in my elbow, I can heal my elbow in almost 30 days where another doctor would do a cortisone shot, which will actually degrade the tissue. It'll actually harm it in the long term.
So if peptides can accelerate healing, decrease muscle pain, enhance cognitive function, and reduce signs of aging, why aren't they prescribed more in mainstream medicine? And why are many of them not FDA approved? I asked the chief science officer at the U.S. Anti-Doping Agency, which has banned several different peptides.
They have to go through both preclinical and clinical trials in human beings in order to be shown to be safe and efficacious for a particular disease condition.
Emergency medicine physician Rajiv Balls says there can be some health risks when using peptides such as growth hormones.
They can cause hormone imbalance in the body, cause you to miss your menstrual cycle, increase your chances of having diabetes or poor regulation of your sugar, and can also cause major mood swings as well.
Another concern, peptides being sold online and on the black market.
Many of those particular compounds and substances that are available on the internet may not have gone through the rigorous quality control or testing process to make sure that they're safe for human consumption.
As the market grows, people are trying to reduce the price. And the best way to reduce the price is to reduce or lower the quality of the ingredients. If you are going to use them, you go to somebody who's certified, who's a physician, and who's getting them from a reliable source as well.
I would say you need to do your homework and get your blood work done and get yourself balanced out because it's a huge help.
Liv Johnson, West 2 News.